The GLC, often held up as the Tory government's strongest opponent, seemed quite restrained by comparison. They only took on an extra 223 people, putting them in 18th place in the national top 20 of offenders. In the eyes of the government, Hackney are the second worst offenders in the country. They've employed an extra 593 full-time people and have no intention of towing the line. They plan to take on 170 more, all in social services. They say they have no choice.
10 years ago, there were 2.4% of the population out of work. It's now 24% of the population out of work. The needs in this borough are enormous now, and those fall on us. Health service cuts, we have to pick them up. The government has this wonderful phrase about community health. That means us doing the work, us employing people. We have to do people's unified housing benefit. The government has forced us to do that. That's 50 staff in that area alone. We have also been forced by this government to take on GLC properties. That was a third more houses, 17,000 more flats that we now run. That's extra staff.
And Hackney is officially recognised as the most deprived borough in the country, with a high rate of pensioners, poor housing and overstretched social services. With an exceptionally high proportion of single-parent families, one priority is day nurseries for the under-fives. But the government say Hackney's recruitment and overspending hasn't all fought deprivation. Some they say is political. If they go on overspending and recruiting, Hackney and the other rebel councils could soon have their rates fixed by law by the government.
Well, it'll land them in greater expenditure, and that lands them in due course if we get our proposals through Parliament for rate capping, as we intend to do. It lands them in danger of falling foul of those new regulations. But in the short term, and far more seriously, and what this is all about, is it means higher rates for their businesses and their shopkeepers and all their employers, and that means higher unemployment in Hackney.
And Hackney already faced the prospect of losing up to £27 million from their budget this year for overspending. Tricia Ingrams in Hackney, Thames News.